Welcome to a new Draw My Life video. Wait. If you're watching this video, it means you're still alive, right? Well, if this is not the case and there is somebody who's dead in here, please don't hesitate to leave a comment sharing your experience. So now, what happens with your body when you die? First of all, the heart stops beating and the brain stops working. This makes muscles and sphincters relax, and blood stops circulating. Blood, obviously, is affected by gravity, so it falls. Well, it would fall if we were standing up, but as we assume we would be laying down, all the blood accumulates in the back part of the body. By then, we will be terribly cold. Since blood is not moving anymore, spreading heat throughout the body, temperature drops drastically. Also, our healthy skin tone turns into a pale ashen color, turning purplish where blood accumulates. Obviously, as we happen to be dead, we don't breathe either, so there is no oxygen reaching cells to produce ATP correctly. However, they continue their activity for some minutes, releasing CO2 accumulated inside, increasing pH and releasing digestive enzymes to the cell membranes. This makes the cell autodigest itself from the outside to the inside, in a process called autolysis. The first organs to suffer this process are the brain and the liver. By the way, liver is the organ that remains warm longer, and that's why we use it to know about time of death. During the following day, the body temperature drops completely and the rigor mortis appears, tensing muscles for about 24 hours. This happens because of two fibrous proteins, actin and myosin. When we die, their filaments are not used anymore, and this provokes body rigidness. It is then that our body starts being affected by those organisms we had peacefully lived with till then. We're talking about those microorganisms normally located in different parts of the body, such as the intestinal flora, which lose control and start going whatever they please. Keeping it short, our old neighbors start eating up our body tissues, eating the damaged cells and liquefying our matter. Yes, very pleasant, all of this. Also, during the process of decomposition, due to the fragmentation of sugars in the organism, gases such as methane, hydrogen sulfide, and ammonia are created. It's now the turn for beetles, flies, and other insects that eat meat to deposit their eggs in the organism. When they leave, the job is almost done. With time, those proteins by which bones are made of also decompose, only leaving the mineral part, called hydroxyapatite, which, at the same time, will also end up disappearing and turning into dust. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to see more Draw My Life videos, subscribe to our channel. See you in the next episode!